Mexican citizenship.
By the way, before you walked in the door today, Pita read to us a list. ESPN made a list of the top fighters age 20 to 40.
Oh.
Did you see you on the list?
Yeah, I think Rick sent me a picture. Yeah, just a picture. Okay. I didn't click on it.
Okay, so I'll tell you. You're 26?
27.
Sorry. You're the number one 27-year-old fighter on the planet. How does that feel?
Feels good.
They
feels the same, man. It feels the same.
Joseph Adorno, also Robert manages, number one. Who was the best 21-year-old, Robert?
The 20, him. That's 20.
That's 20. But who's 21? You remember?
21. Haney.
Haney, but you thought it was maybe Virgil Ortiz, right?
Virgil Ortiz.
So it could be Haney or Virgil.
Yeah, but Haney's a world champion, so.
That would have mean you had three people on the list. Wow. 23 is Benavidez. 24, I don't remember. 25 was Tank. 26, don't remember. 27, you. 28, don't remember. 29, Canelo. Do you believe Canelo was only 29?
Canelo's only 29?
Yeah, it's crazy. I feel like he's been around forever.
Tell you, he could fight another 10 years, man, that dude. Was it like a cheetah?
What makes Canelo so good, Robert? What's his secret of success?
Look, I'm sure he trains hard too.
He does train hard.
I see him videos. He trains very, very hard, and he's got a great team behind him. No, he's got experience because he's got all those fights. He's had a lot of big names, man.
52 pro fights, something.
Yeah, already 52.
Maybe more even.
You know, that's what makes him so good.
Maybe 56.
Because I was watching his first fight when he fought here in the United States, not in California, but in the United States, against Cotto's brother. And wow, you can see the difference. So he's got so much better, he's improved. And you can tell that comes from training his ass off. Obviously he has a good team behind him and giving him the right fights. The sparring partners.
He's very smart.
The fights. Yeah. He's fought a lot of great names.
He fought Mosley. He fought Cotto, Danny fought. Jacobs, Triple G.
He's fought a lot of great names, man. Austin Trout, Lada. He's had a lot of great names in his.
You're right. Both of them southpaws, hard to fight.
He's had a lot of great names. So he's learned so much. He's gotten so much better. That's why I'm telling you.
He fought.
A lot of people don't like it, but he is the best Mexican fighter right now, and maybe of all times. Even though a lot of Mexican fighters and Mexican fans are against him, because maybe they're never. I don't think they're ever gonna see him. I don't think they're gonna see Canelo in one of those Eric Morales, Marc Antonio Barrera type of fights. Arce versus
he doesn't need to though.
Hussein or whatever. They're not gonna see the Marquez Pacquiao fights. Chavez, Melrick Taylor. They're probably never gonna see him in those type of fights because he doesn't need to be in those type of fights to be great. But that's what Mexican fans want to see. They want to see him get dropped, get beat up, get up, and then win by a knockout. They want to see him in one of those type of fights. They want to see him losing every round and then knocking his opponent out in the last round. That's what they want to see to accept him.
Not gonna happen. He doesn't need to, Robert. He's dominating.
Dominating. He's fighting all those great names, and he's dominating. And yes,
and he's getting paid.
Look, yes, when it comes to money, you could put all the great Mexican champions, put all their purses together, and he still and Canelo makes more than all of them. It's true.
So they're jealous sometimes. Jealousy, Robert. People are jealous.
Also, sometimes they also have a. Sometimes they could also have a point and have a reason. Look, because us as fans, I was there when Cotto fought Canelo, and I was with Mikey, and I think Pita was with us too. When Canelo fought Cotto, and we all thought Canelo could have done more, could have risked a little bit more to maybe win by knockout, to maybe put a better fight for the crowd. I think so. I really believe so.
But Cotto didn't want to get knocked out himself.
No, but also Canelo was fighting smart enough to just win. He knew he was ahead. He was winning. So that's all, that's what maybe there we were also one of those that said, man, I think he could have done more. He could have pushed himself a little bit more to win by knockout. And maybe he would have got the knockout. But he didn't have to. He was still winning. So that's why he gets a lot of criticism, because maybe he doesn't push himself to that extra power, you know, I don't know how to say it.
But in the other side, to be fair, if you don't need to, why go that way, Robert? It's about winning.
Mayweather has said it.
Win seven rounds.
All you need to win is seven rounds.
That's true.
So you know, so Mayweather doesn't get that. Mayweather doesn't get that. But Canelo does, because the Mexicans are different. The Mexicans want to see him differently. They want to see him get beat up, get cut, get dropped, and get up and then still win. That's what the Mexicans want to see him. But we're never going to see that from Canelo. And that's why I think Canelo's the best Mexican right now, and maybe of all times. You know, we're just never going to see him in those type of fights. Because he fights smart, and he does enough to win.
That's true.
Would I want to see him in one of those tough fights? Yes, I would want to see him, you know, like I was telling you against Cotto. I would have loved him to push himself a little bit more, risk himself a little more to win by knockout. Maybe take a few hits, maybe get punched, but get the knockout. But he didn't have to. You know, I think he's smart.
He's a $400 million reacher, so.
He can still fight another 10 years. And still be healthy. So
he did fight Triple G and took Triple G's best punch.
Yeah.
People are commenting on the live.
No, he did. He fought
Triple G. And he beat him clearly in the second fight, Robert.
I think he clearly won the second fight. The first one was the one that was a little bit questionable. But the second fight, I think he really won. I think.